Hello everyone. Now in this session we will know about the next concept, that one is a case study, that one is Oracle architecture of the database management system. How exact the Oracle work with the database management system architecture. Now it contains a two main component, that means the instant and database. Now we will know about what exact the instant under the Oracle architecture. That means instant, some memory structures and background processes, that's called the instant, right? Some memory structures and background processes, that's called the instant of Oracle architecture. Now we will go in detail about the instant. This one is a scenario, or maybe this diagram showing the instant about the Oracle architecture. Now SGA, that one is a system global area. If we look, this one is a system global area. It contains a buffer cache, redo log buffer, large pool, Java pool. Then again one more point, that one is a shared pool. It contains a library cache and dictionary cache. This is the SGA, system global area. Now the PGA, software area code, and then these are the some points which one is related to this, that's whole called the instant, right? Now we will go with the one by one. System global area is a primary memory structures. Oracle DBA talks about the memory, it means the SGA, right? Now this area is broken into a few of a part memory. It's a buffer cache, shared pool, a redo log buffer, large pool, and the Java pool, right? This one is a pool, or we can say that this one is a memory. Now we will go with the one by one, what exact the buffer cache, right? It's a buffer cache under the HGA, system global area, stores the data block that are retrieved from the data files. Means when we get some data from the database, it's stored under the buffer cache. Now shared pool, it's divided into a two part. Shared pool divided into a two parts. That one is a library cache and dictionary cache. Library cache stores the commonly used SQL and PLSQL statements. Stored commonly used, means we can say that mostly used SQL, PLSQL statements, managed by the least recently used algorithm. That one is managed with the least recently, means used SQL and PLSQL queries, which one is stored under the library cache. Now the dictionary cache stores the object definitions in a database, columns, tables, indexes, users and privileges. That one is use of dictionary caches. That is the shared pool. Now the redo log buffer, a DML statement will be generates a redo entry. Redo entry information about all data changes made by the user stored in a redo log files. That one is we already know about the redo operation. That one is redo log buffer stores the related information of redo operations. We can say that. Now the large pool is the optional area of memory in SGA. Reduce the burden placed on the shared pool, also used for input output process. Means a large pool, which one is reduce the work of a shared pool, and that one is definitely related to the input output process also, right? Now the Java pool used for parsing of the Java command. If we run the Java commands with a particular application, then it uses the Java pool. Now the program global area is related to a HGA, right? We already know about the HGA and the use of that. Now the PGA, that one is program global area, is a result of SQL statement parsing, is stored in a library cache. Result of SQL statement parsing is stored in a library cache, but value of the binding variable will be stored in a PGA. Value related to that query, which one is stored in a program global area, right? Because of the private or not shared among user, PGA is also used for the short area. That one is the use of program global area, which stores the variable values. Right. Then software area code location in a memory where the Oracle application software resides. This one is used for the storing the value of a variable. Software area code, we copy the code, application code under this software area code, right? Now the Oracle processes, if we go with the diagram, Oracle processes, this HGA is done, then PGA is done, then software area code is done. Now we will go with the processes of the Oracles. Two categories of processes that run with an Oracle database. It's a user processes and system processes. Now user processes that gives the input to the HGA, like a user send some query, then HGA manage that, receive that query, then server process with the PGA, work on that, and then Oracle instant or under the Oracle instant particular session is executed. This is simply the Oracle processes. It's a user process and it's a system process. Now the Oracle background processes behind the screen that work together with the memories. Now the DWN, LGWR, CKPT, these are the processes, right? If we go with the first diagram and if we check it with the, these are the processes. Now which one is system, means Oracle process, we can say that. Now the Oracle background processes, what is the DBWN, database return writer process, is used to write data from buffer cache into the data file. Means whatever the memory is used under the Oracle architecture, if we write something under a particular buffer, then it need some process. That processes are, that one is the data writer process is used, database writer process is used to write data from buffer cache into the data file. Then LGWR, write redo entries from redo log buffer into the redo log file. That means when we done the process, then it's stored that logs on a secondary or the on a disk. That one is written by the LGWR process. Now CKPT, checkpoint, is a process to give a signal to a DBW, also update the data file and controls the file header when log file switch occurs. That one is checkpoint process, which one is maintain the checkpoints with the help of the log file. Then the SMON, that one is a system monitoring process, is used to recover the system crash or the instant failure. That one is a SMON, is a system monitoring process. So when the particular system fails, then this process initiate the particular program, recovery program. Now PMON, that one is a process monitoring process used to clean up the work after failed process by rolling back the transaction and releasing other resources. That one is a process monitoring process. Like if system monitoring process is executed, or it may be a particular query transaction is failed, then system monitoring process, which one is executed something, then this process monitoring process monitor this particular system monitoring process. It may be the scenario. Now this one is diagrammatical view, like PMON, SMON, that one is a shared pool, database buffer cache, large pool, redo log, we can say that is a SGA, Java pool, and then it provides this PMON, SMON, LGWR, CKPT, DWR, these are the Oracle processes, right? That process is divided into two category, is Oracle processes and the user processes. Now these are the Oracle processes, which one is supports the execution of the instant. Now the Oracle instant, now this whole calls the Oracle instant, and the Oracle database, that one is actual, we store the data on the disk, that is the Oracle database. Now the ARCH process invoke when DB running in a archive log mode, when archiving redo logs, redo log touched by the several background processes, right? Archive, which one is get the data from the redo log file but maybe archived redo log file, maintain that details under the archived redo log. Then LGWR process copies the log buffer content to the online redo log file. This one is a LGWR, it's a redo log, which one is a redo log group, which one is copy this redo log into the redo log files under the disk, right? That one is a LGWR use. Now the database two main structure, logical structure and physical structure. Logical structure, DB divided into a smaller logical unit to manage, store and retry the retried data efficiently. This one is the explanation about this scenario about the Oracle architecture. Now the Oracle logical structure of the database, that one is a table space system. It's a database, then it's a, divided into a table, then table divided into a segment, then segment that one is divided into a data block, right? Then it's a logical structure. Now table space, grouping a logical database object, it is composed by one or more data files, three type of of a table space in Oracle. It's a permanent table space, is undo or rollback table space, or the temporary table spaces. Now the what's the segment? Table space is further broken into a segment, right? Table space divided into a segment. Segment is used to store the same type of object, right? Table stored in a segment within its index. Segment is a container for the object, table, view, then the packages, indexes. This one is a use of that. Then the packages and the indexes. There are the 11 type of segment in Oracle. The segment types under the Oracle, that is a table, table partitions, index, index partition, cluster, rollback, deferred rollback, temporary, cache, log segment, log index. These are the some segments under the Oracle database architecture. Now the And this is simply the explanation about the Oracle database architecture, that is Oracle logical structure about the database. Now this one is Oracle processes and the Oracle database connectivity, or it may be a working of the database, Oracle database and the Oracle instant, we can say that. Now this one is Oracle process, that's run with the two process, user process and system processes. Now this is the Oracle instant. It contains sub points. That one is a SGA, it's a system global area. It contains some memory use or the buffer use. Now the particular other operations are related to the instant, and which one is helps to execute the user queries. That one is simply the Oracle architecture. Thank you.